Hey, I'm Kyle, and this is our third video on restoring a 1999 TR20 with my father, Chris. If you've missed the previous videos in this series, I'll link them on screen here so you can get yourself familiarized with the project. If you're new here and you have any interest in fishing, boating, marine repair and maintenance slash restoration, then I would encourage you to hit the subscribe button as that keeps us motivated to keep making these videos for you. So without any further ado, let's get to today's video. So to pick things up where we left off from the last video, we had got the fuel tank out and it was absolutely disgusting under there, 23 years of grime, and just wanted to show this super satisfying clip of cleaning all the gunk out from under there. It was really gross, but oh man, I love doing stuff like this. So satisfying. So the plan was to use this old truck cab roller dolly, if you want to call it, repurpose it to get the boat off the trailer and onto something like a stand while we work on it in the shop. Was a great idea in principle, but unfortunately we ended up having to abandon it in favor of another route we went. Here we're just showing some of the damage that you can see while the boat is still on the trailer. Some holes clean through the transom, nice. Lots of chipping, cracking, impact marks. And on top of that, I'm not sure if I mentioned it in the last video or not, but this boat has some serious hull osmosis from sitting on some wet bunks too long. So after we realized we weren't going to be able to use the dolly system, we abandoned that idea for this day and just worked on getting the trailer disassembled as much as we could to try and make our life easier when we were taking the boat off the trailer and trying to do it inside the shop. So our next plan involved lumber, 2x4s. I'm not sure if you've ever seen people stack sections of 2x4 on top of each other to make stands for cars usually, but we were going to try and adapt that to use these to hold the boat up in the air. So we had just built a stack of 16 inch long 2x4s overlaid on each other, and then I made these, I think they were 9-degree angle off cuts to put on top that then we would put a 2x4 on and wrap that in some carpet to try and protect the hull. And that would allow us to place these where the bunks aren't on the trailer, because that was going to be the big problem with using what we had, that metal frame with the casters, is we weren't gonna be able to make it wide enough to where we would be able to set the boat anywhere where there wasn't hull repair needed. So here we are just cutting some old carpet up so I can put it on top of a couple, I think 24 inch 2x4 sections that we would eventually be setting the boat onto. So the taller ones are going to be for the stern of the boat. And then we had also made a third stand that we were going to use on the keel of the boat with a couple 2x4s side by side for a total width of 7 or 8 inches. Here we are, here's the nice finished product ready to go under the boat. As you can see, the three stands there. We managed to wrangle up a couple extra hands to help us on the actual lifting day. And after a very thorough safety meeting by the foreman on site, we were able to start actually trying to remove the boat from the trailer. So the basic plan was to lift the hull from the transom using the jack plate in hopes that that would reduce the amount of friction on the bunks. And with a couple guys on the front of the boat, the wheels chocked, and somebody at the back on the cherry picker, we'd be able to slide the boat off the trailer a decent amount. It ended up working pretty well. We did manage to get the boat slid back probably 24 to 36 inches, which is exactly what we needed, because at that point, then we could set the hull down onto the stern or transom stance that we had made. And then we could start lifting from the keel of the boat and trying to walk or work the trailer out from underneath of the boat. So here you can see we're ready to set the stern stands. I gotta come up with a name for these things underneath of the hull. And that means that we can start focusing our efforts on lifting the front of the boat. These homemade stands ended up working out perfect. They cradle the hull contour great with a couple layers of carpet. It really spreads out the load and they do the trick on a budget. I don't know how else I would have done this. So here you can see they're under there quite nicely, very comfortable height for getting it off the trailer. And we can move on to getting the front of the boat lifted. So the basic plan was just with two regular floor jacks to use a block of wood, lift the keel, move the trailer forward until that jack encountered a cross member, and then with a second jack, go in behind the cross member that the front jack is hitting. At that point, we can let down the front jack, move the trailer forward until the second jack hits another cross member, and then simply rinse and repeat until you're past all the cross members and axles. I think in total we had to move the jacks or re-jack the hull maybe about four times in total to get the trailer fully clear. One of the biggest wins for the day was right at the end when we realized that our final jack placement was going to be enough where the boat was actually balanced past its center point and we were clear.
Boys, listen to me.
I know, you're right.
It's flying. We can pull the trailer out.
Okay. Now, okay.
At this point, there's no more load on the trailer, and we are good to completely remove it and block up the hull.
Okay, now we gotta go that way, boys. Like, we gotta start turning or we're not gonna get out the door.
Hard. There you go.
Now she'll go out. Close the door.
Sheesh.
All right. Bring your...
That's a flying Triton. Hey. Nice work, guys. Well, there you have it. We've gotten the boat separated from the trailer, and at this point, they somewhat become two separate projects. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch these videos. It's very encouraging. Huge shout out again to the Triton Boat Owners Facebook group. You guys have been so supportive and have given us so much additional information on this project. So huge shout out to you guys. If you've made it to the end of the video, I encourage you to subscribe. It seems like you're enjoying the content. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.